गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज प्रोफेसर किरण पोद्दार, अंगड़ी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड मैनेजमेंट, बेलगावी। टुडे विल डिस्कस अ डेरिवेशन ऑफ वन डायमेंशनल हीट इक्वेशन। इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड थ्रू दिस वी आर गोइंग टू डिराइव एंड फॉर्मुलेट अ डेरिवेशन फॉर वन डायमेंशनल हीट इक्वेशन। सो लेट अस कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन द स्टेटमेंट हियर। व्हाट इट सेज, वी हैव फ्यू एम्पिरिकल लॉज with respect to heat flow. Whenever we take a heat flow in a body or in a material, then some of the empirical laws will be followed. So what are those laws? First, heat flows from higher end to lower end. It is understood. Heat flows from higher end to lower end. If you give some temperature, for example, if you take a cup of tea, a hot cup of tea, and if you keep it for a while, then automatically the hotness of the tea automatically it transports towards the cold. Means what? The temperature from higher end to lower end it will flow. Second, the amount of heat in a body is proportional to mass and temperature. Amount of heat in a body is proportional to mass and temperature. We need to understand this again. So here what happens, amount of heat, it is with respect to mass and temperature of the body. For example, if you take a material and the amount of heat present in it, it depends on what? It depends on its mass as well as a temperature. For example, if you take a material and heat is transferred to that. For example, if you take a small material, and with respect to that we'll keep one more material, big in size. So same amount of heat will be given, and if you touch that material, you will come to know the material in a large size, that will the heat will be more in that one. That is because of mass as well as the temperature. Fine. Third, the rate of heat flow across an area is proportional to temperature gradient normal to the area, where the constant of proportionality K, that is nothing but thermal conductivity, will be there. So if these three laws are followed, then it is very easy to understand one dimensional heat equation. Okay, so let us start with the solution. So before going through the solution, we'll concentrate on the diagram here. So this diagram will help us to understand the concept of all these things with respect to the empirical laws. So very first, we consider a homogeneous bar of constant cross sectional area, A. Okay. Then we'll take few more terms. Let us take rho. What is rho? Rho be the density. Then S be the specific heat. Then we take K. What is K? K will be the thermal conductivity of the material. This be the thermal conductivity of the material. These are the notations which we are going to use. Fine. So if you see this diagram, how this diagram will be described? Here, let us take the slide of this bar is insulated. The slide be insulated so that the stream line of heat flows or how? Either they will be parallel and they will be perpendicular to the cross-sectional area that I take A. means what? If it these slides are insulated, because we need to handle this, so these sides are insulated. When these sides are insulated, automatically what happens? The stream flow, because heat is entered into the body, and these sides, its sides are insulated. When these sides are insulated, then automatically whenever you touch the side, you will not feel any heat here. So, but heat is present in the body. So that heat present in the body will flow across the area. Means what? Heat present in the body, it may flow in this direction or it may flow in this direction, upward, down or whatever it is. Therefore, sometimes it will be parallel to x-axis, or sometimes it will be perpendicular to x-axis, also with respect to y-axis. Means heat present in the body flows across perpendicular as well as parallel to the area. Okay, next. In this one, let us take one end of the bar. One end of the bar be taken as origin. Origin O means this one. This will be treated, one end is O. And let us choose a direction of a heat flow. Direction of the heat flow will be taken as positive along with x-axis. Means when this heat flows, it will be treated as positive along with x-axis. Therefore, we consider this as a function. What kind of function? So we'll consider, let us take u is equal to u of x comma t. Here we don't call it as x-axis and y-axis. This as x-axis and y-axis. We take it as x-axis and this will be t-axis. T instead of xy, we take x and t, where x and t are the variables. This function u is equal to u of x comma t will be taken as, it is nothing but the temperature of the slab at a distance x from origin O. This one slab means what? You can see the slab means what? The from the distance from origin to this slab. Slab is given here. Fine. So that is nothing but function. Function is u is equal to u of x comma t. That will be the temperature of the slab at a distance x from origin. Means from initial point of it. Therefore, we consider an element of a bar between the bounded area, we can call, or between the plane. What is that plane? We can see P, Q, R, S, and here it is P dash, Q dash, R dash, S dash. Therefore, the element of a bar between P, Q, R, S and P dash, Q dash, R dash, S dash. At a distance X means this distance from the origin will be taken as X, and this distance from the origin up till here will be taken as X plus delta X. Means it is understood this distance is delta X. Therefore X and X plus delta X respectively from the origin O. This is the thing. Then we'll take it as, let delta U, what it is, it will be the increment given to it. So delta U be the change of temperature in a slab of thickness delta x. We know this, this is the thickness delta x. Thickness of a slab means what? This portion from here to here, this is called as a thickness of the slab. That thickness of the slab is taken as delta x. So delta u will be the change of temperature in a slab of thickness delta x of a bar. Okay. Then let us consider mass, because mass is very much required as per the second imperial law, because amount of heat in a body is proportional to mass and temperature. So that we need to understand. So related to temperature, we have the statement. Now related to mass, let us take the mass of the element will be taken as mass is related to what? Area, density and thickness of the material. Area, density and thickness of the material altogether, it is called as mass of the element. Therefore, the quantity of the heat stored in a slab, heat stored in this slab, slab element will be taken as, what is the heat stored in a slab? So this is a slab now. This is one slab we have. So heat entered into it and it exits from this point. When heat entered here till existence, it exit, the heat will be stored in this slab. So heat stored in the slab of the element will be taken as what? For that automatically mass comes, because area with respect to density with respect to thickness is covered. Therefore it will be A into rho comes. Fine. Then specific heat is also going to play a role here along with delta X and delta U. Delta U is what? Change in temperature of the slab. And A into rho into delta X is what? Mass. Because we have the second empirical law. What it says? The second empirical law says, you can see here, the second empirical law says the amount of heat in a body is proportional to its mass and temperature. So because of that, what we do? Temperature will be taken in terms of delta U and mass will be taken in terms of A into rho into delta X. So A into rho means area, a product of area, thickness, specific heat, then thickness of the slab, then change in the temperature of the slab of thickness. This altogether, it will be a quantity of heat stored in a slab. It means that much amount of heat is stored in this slab. Here, it is stored. Okay. Therefore, next let us take, hence, the rate of increase of heat. If you increase the amount of heat in a slab, then what happens? The rate of increase in heat in a slab element is given by R is equal to area, density, specific heat, then thickness. What else is there? You can see quantity of heat stored in a slab is this. Then when we increase, what will be the rate of change of increment in the stored heat? That is what? Area, rho, specific heat, thickness. Then what remains? It remains delta U. Okay. So this is equal to delta U. So this delta U means what? It is rate of change of temperature in a slab. Okay, change of temperature in a slab. That change of temperature in a slab will be with respect to T. Therefore, that will be taken as dou U by dou T. And we call it as equation number 1. Because whenever we take rate of increase in a heat, that heat increase is having a connection with respect to time. Therefore, the rate of change of temperature with respect to time will be taken dou U by dou T. Then, if Ri will be what is the rate of inflow, because rate of increase in the heat means what? The rate of increase in the heat means it may be inflow of the heat or it may be increase in outflow also. therefore we take RI with the rate of inflow of heat and RO is the rate of outflow of heat. Means what? When we enter the amount of heat, that will be taken as RI. Okay, RI, because R is nothing but rate of increase of heat in a slab. So RI will be inflow of heat and RO will be outflow heat. That we need to remember. Therefore, RI will be taken as minus KA into dou U by dou X at X. This is inflow. And outflow will be considered as RO. That will be considered as minus KA into dou U by dou X at X plus delta X. Altogether, we call it as equation number 2. What it means? RI is nothing but rate of inflow heat. RO is nothing but rate of outflow heat. Rate of inflow heat is having a connection with what? Thermal conductivity, area, and dou U by dou T. Dou U by dou T means what? Rate of change of temperature with respect to X. Fine. Why it is taken with respect to X? Previously it was with respect to T. Because we are taking it with respect to X, because when the heat flows, it flows along with X axis. Either it may be inflow or it outflow, that will be with respect to X, because it is moving along with X axis. Because of that we take. Then what this K? K is a thermal conductivity, A is area. Fine. Then what this negative sign indicates? Where this negative sign indicates empirical law 1. It is due to empirical law 1. What was that empirical law 1? Empirical law 1 says the heat always heat flows from higher end to lower end. This you can see. Heat flows from higher end to lower end. Means if you take higher end is positive and lower end is negative. So automatically it starts flowing with negative direction. So this is because of that negative is taken. Because always heat, it may be inflow or outflow, it flows from higher end to lower end. Okay. Then let us take equation number 1 and 2. These two equations, how they can be written. Then R is equal to. We have from equation number 1 and 2. What is understood? R is nothing but amount of heat stored in a, rate of change of heat stored in a slab. Means here. Then RI is nothing but inflow of heat. RO is nothing but outflow of heat. Means what? Amount of heat stored is here, inflow is here and outflow is here. So how do you come to know ki what amount of heat is stored inside? For example, some amount of heat is taken inflow and certain amount of heat flows outside. Then you can see whatever amount of heat is inserted and what amount of heat is exit. Then if you take that whole amount of heat minus this, then automatically we come to know what is the storage inside. What is the storage inside? Okay. So that is nothing but R, amount of heat present in the slab is nothing but amount of heat inserted, that is inflow, minus amount of heat took exit, that is outflow. Fine. Therefore, what is the meaning of R from equation number 1? A into rho into S into delta X dou U by dou T. Therefore, this R is nothing but A rho S delta X dou U by dou T is equal to Ri, what is Ri? minus Ka into dou u by dou x at x, then minus Ro, what is Ro? Minus of this, so it becomes minus Ka into dou u by dou x at x plus delta x. Therefore, A into rho into S of delta x into dou u by dou t is equal to minus of minus is plus. So, I'll take this term first and then it one. But here we understood Ka is constant. Therefore, we'll take that as a constant term. Fine. So, we take it as Ka into dou u by dou x from x plus delta x minus Ka into dou u by dou x at x. Therefore, here Ka is constant. Keep it out. Therefore, Ka is taken common. Then what we get? Dou u by dou x from x plus delta x minus dou u by dou x at x. Fine. On other hand, what is remaining? A into rho into S into delta x into dou u by dou t. But what I do, I'll take dou u by dou t. I'll keep only dou u by dou t here. Remaining things will be sent to other end. When these things will send to other end, then this delta x will come to the other end. So that I'll take here. Okay, this is over. Then what remains? A rho S. A rho S means what? This comes as 1 divided by A rho S. Okay. A get cancelled. Therefore, dou u by dou t is equal to k divided by rho into S into dou u by dou x from x plus delta x minus dou u by dou x from x divided by delta x. Fine. We call it as equation number 3. So let us apply limit on RHS of this equation. On RHS, then it becomes dou u by dou t is equal to k by rho into S into limit as delta x tends to 0 of dou u by dou x from x plus delta x minus dou u by dou x from x, this divided by delta x. Fine. Then by the definition of partial derivatives, what it is? Definition of partial derivative, what it means? What it means in the sense, what is the meaning of this basic definition of partial derivative? Because as per the partial derivative, what it says? The partial derivative says that we know the definition, basic definition of partial derivative. It is something like this. If limit of u of x plus delta x comma y minus u of x y by with respect to delta x will be dou u by dou x. But here, it is not just a function. It is already first order derivative. So, because of that, what happens? This will be taken as, this result will be taken as dou u by dou t is equal to k by rho s into, what about this? This is nothing but already first order, so it becomes second order. Means dou square u by dou x square. Fine. Then what we do? Let us put this k divided by rho s is equal to c square. What is c square? Which is nothing but diffusivity of the substance. Okay? Diffusivity of the substance. Therefore, this equation becomes, I call it as equation number 4 now. So, this equation number 4 becomes dou u by dou t is equal to k by rho s is nothing but c square of dou square u by dou x square. Or else we can represent it as ut is equal to c square u x x. And this represents one dimensional heat equation. Thank you.